Alright, a little talkative today, so I'm going to talk about, the taboo of Catholics and Mormons. It's just because I am betwixt from both. Now, when I'm looking at, you know, analysis of Catholics, I can just have such a big anger at them, you know, like, they're just controllers, they're condemners, they're guilt mongers. And then I'm like, okay, well, let's bring it back, you know, let's bring it back to why, and how they became that way. Well, when we look at the tactics, we look at the tactics of confessional. We look at the tactics of, oh my gosh, it's with one person. When they have a confessional moment, it's with one person only. So I'm like, well, wait a minute, doesn't that raise the ante of gossip being their run with, their relay? Doesn't that make gossip their Pandora's box to just open up all the time? If I gossip with you, you know, if I gossip with that person, you know, it becomes like little tiny confessional states. I'm going to have a confessional state with you, one person. This is our little niche that we talk about. And over here, this is our little deal we talk about. So when we start looking at controllers, ye are, you know, look at it as almost like a spider that has this little discussional of hold, and that little discussional hold, and this little discussional hold, and that little discussional hold, but all in all of these different people's minds, and yet none of them are communicating. None of the others are communicating with the same clarity. You understand? It's not a group discussion. It is a group, it's a separated discussion. It's a gossip to gossip as a confessional. Think of it that way. Each gossip is just like meeting with their, what do they call them? Their pastors or whatever. So, when we head over to the Mormons, I'm like, well, that's a different group. They're extremely verbal. Probably hence the way why I'm online all the time. We're extremely verbal people. And when I say verbal, I mean we are up there with testimonial in front of the entire group of churchgoers. So when you have a testimonial in front of all those people, there is no hidden wooden cubby with that church person, that, what do you call him, a priest? Yeah. There is not that hidden secret zone. It's in front of everybody. You know, the girl says, I ran out in the street in my panties, and I was drunk, and I tried to cause a car accident. You know, she has to say that. She says that in front of everybody. She doesn't say it in front of just her little priest in the cubbyhole, or just her girlfriend over there in her little gossip cubbyhole. You know what I'm saying? So it creates different people. It creates different people. So they have a different mindset. The Mormons have a different mindset. It's much more open, much more shared. Your actions are not hidden. They are open and they are shared. Whereas with the Catholics, whoa, good heavens. I mean, if you're looking at secrets and things locked away and buried and I would look at the Catholics. I would look at the Catholics. I also look at higher rates of health disorders with the Catholics, because all that secrecy, all that secrecy and all that manipulation, all that trying to control, this person knows this about me, or this person knows that about what I said about that other person, that creates a very, very dangerous health state. So we'll look at that as being possibly, you can probably say it, Catholics don't live as long as Mormons. So we're looking at the constrained, and then, okay, well, I was like, forget Catholics, I don't even want to talk about Catholics, they only condemn me, they only put me on a guilt trip. Well, that's what this discussion was about, was trying to figure out why, and where that guilt trip came from. And is it, do they all have a priest syndrome? They all want to be that priest, you know. One side or the other, you know. Are you the confessional one, or am I, you know? So when you talk to a Catholic, maybe look at it that way. You are possibly, I mean, they're strict from the very beginning. That religion is a very strict ritual hall. So when you're looking at something that's that strict and that dun-da-dun-da-da in the brain, you have got to imagine yourself as either, when you talk to a Catholic, you are either the priest or the confessional. You're the confessor, one or the other. Okay, so it's just whatever game they're playing at that moment. So anywho, I don't know why, but I'm woo-swooing the Mormons at the moment as a balanced group. As much as, yeah, they did predict Nibiru, or they did predict the what do we call it, the planet arrival. They did predict all of that, and what am I supposed to do about that? That's kind of cool, because yes, there is a planet headed our way, so that's kind of interesting. Maybe they have something there in the documentation that they listened to. So yeah, anyway. Fun. So so here we are in this world of open discussions, and everything is going on the soap opera talk show. Well, don't invite a Catholic, that's all I can say. Don't invite them, they won't be open. They'll just be like I don't know, they won't give you the data, they won't give you the info. And I'm just like, well, when it comes to interrogation, you know, if you're going to interrogate anybody, good gosh, interrogate Mormons, I guess. They'll just talk. And what, you know? What are you going to do with a Catholic? You know, maybe they're not good to be interrogated, you know, in a group. Maybe they're just not good that way. No, I don't know. When you get into the mafia and you get into all of that, it's just like, zoom, everything points at the Catholics. You know, just like a divining rod. And I was just like, well, that's an easy keep. Also, it's easy to keep a mafia in that state. When you have, that's it. You know, I'm going to talk to you only, and this is hush. Or else, very easy. Person to person to person to person. Hey, Catholic mafia. No, not necessarily. You can't say Catholic mafia, but Catholic people easily controlled by a mafia. So. Anyway, so where we are, the hush state. And then where's that last thing I was about to say? Yeah, and so victim, Mormon victim, easy prey. Well, my gosh, all of our openness, I guess we are easy prey. Because, yeah, there's a world of what do we call them? Thieves? There's a world of thieves out there, and maybe we are too, what is the word? Maybe we're too innocent. You understand? We're just too innocent. Anyhoots. So, That's all. I wasn't going to go into anything else with Judea or anything like that. No, this is just the Mormons and the Catholic discussion. All right. Yeah.